couple of, actually some year ago, I've made a video where I explained the difference between insanity and being crazy. Some of the comments say that I was not so good to understand, so I make a different one where I talk about the same topic. So, the difference between insanity and being crazy is that a crazy person knows that he is different than the majority, but actually not give so much about it. In contrary with one insane person, how is out touch with reality. The form of the euphemism that they use in the psychology is by psychotic. The terminology of insane is used in law most of the time as one euphemism for being out of touch with reality. A crazy person is somebody like Malcolm X, who was radical but know how the majority thinks about him. But no matter if the majority of the white man hate him, he stands still on his side because he know that his side was right. Vegans can be maybe crazy, but that don't mean that they're being insane. They know that the majority, because they be brainwashed from a young age to disregard the life of animals. That the majority believes that the commodification, enslavement and exploitation and turning animals in inanimate objects, that is normal and natural. Just like slave masters believe in one time and call anybody crazy that was against slavery and expose and tell the truth about the system of slavery of humans. So, being crazy is not so much an insult, as long as you know the difference between the two. All revolutionary activists in whole history were crazy. Some maybe more than others. But it's being used as one weapon by a status quo. Just like the terminology of cult. For Morrison, the world water culture and cult means the same. Just like the religion. But the status quo and the politicians have polluted the words. Now, in the minds of the majority, it means something different, something creepy and crazy, or sometimes even insane. As Malcolm X have once said, yeah, I know that he's not was not vegan, but I think he will be if I understand how the animal agriculture industry also harm people in poor countries and black people in that ratios. Even if he not give about the life of animals, I think he will see why you, even if you not give about animals, you have to stop consuming the dismembered corpses and the things that come out of animals. Even if it only been for humans in poor countries. He have once have said, one great thing But I think that that young people have to learn in this age is to learn to think for themselves. It's good to have a wide open mind and look what anybody else have to say. But when it comes to take action, you have to weigh anything on the zone and put the trash out and use logic, morality, compassion. When the people that empower around you create an image to justify something that is bad, they use the press, and they use the press to create a humanitarian image for a devil. It creates a devil image for a humanitarian. This is the press, one irresponsible powers. If you not be careful, let you hate the freedom fighters and love the terrorists. It's crazy what people do on a daily basis. And you know what's more insane than slaughterhouses? Meat eaters. Walking around if the lifestyle is causing no harm. If what I do is normal and natural, and that it being moral and justifiable. When anybody with a bitch, with a little bit of common sense, will understand that they're not being so. But you think that all the animals eat? Think you that they're being vegetarians? Live only on air and light? Of course not. Around something like 70% of all the corn, greens and lentils on the world we feed to around something like 60 billion land animals in animal slavery, in non-humane human slavery. For the people that know what a humane is, humane of homini is the true species where humans belongs. Humans are the only surviving species of the homini, of the hominal species. So that's our species. Technological and the kind of being you being. Just like gorillas belong to the gorillas and to the primates. Awaken humanity. If you are not the victim, don't imagine it entirely from your point of view. Because if you are not the victim, it becomes pretty easy to mark your victims, make fun of their entire existence. Say that it's stupid and that they're stupid and dirty. That it is stupid to want to fight for their rights. But when you are the victim, mate, things look a lot different from the angle. Don't make excuses. But if you are the victim, won't you then also that somebody make excuses for you, for your suffering? Don't want you that somebody stand up for your right to be free? Think you not that the animals that we torture and murdered and turned in food want the exact same things? To be free, to be happy, to live in freedom, live with the creatures that they want in their life. With their family members, grow up happy, without fear of a brutal ending. Peace of always to trump violence. How can anybody claim that animals are not abused, exploited, and murdered and raped when they're put any year with metal objects in the vaginas of female animals to impregnate them with bull semen, with cows, or bear semen with pigs, and then steal their children from them. How can somebody claim that it's slaughter, aka murder or assassination? Euphemisms. Political shit to confuse. And that it can be done with humanity, with humility, with kindness and compassion. When they're being cut in pieces, when they come out the animal concentration camps. We are so deluded. Sorry, I know, the truth is harsh, it's painful. As Schopenhauer once have said, tell a man a lie and he become angry. But when you tell them the truth, they become furious. What's the excuse for causing the least amount of harm possible on this planet? That's what we vegans ask you. It's time to answer. But you're so selfish that you think that your life and the life of people in poor countries that die from starvation be more important than some minutes of satisfaction of your taste buds. Humans don't need animal products to survive. So, saying that you need your protein, when there are being more than 7.5 million human vegans on this planet, that proved the fact that you don't need animals to survive. 2% to your world population. Do the map. Don't make stupid and insane excuses for harming innocent beings. How have nothing harmed you ever in your whole life? A pig, a cow, a chicken have harmed nobody. So, are the vegans crazy? Or society insane? Is it not extremist to feed around something like 70% of all the corns, all the lentils, all the soy, to 60 billion land animals, and also something like the health of all the marine species that been catched by fishing industries worldwide? The map. You don't have to be Einstein to figure out this. That animals, humans and the earth suffer all from animal agriculture, or so like they want to call it, animal husbandry. So euphemistic and deceitful. I hope that you respect my willingness to say what needs to be said. Martin the King have once said, you have to come one day that you have to take a position that's not popular, that's not political correct, but you can't just say that it's been right. And you have to stand up for what's right. Even if it's been against popular opinions. Maybe that kind of crazy. But maybe I've been just the right kind of crazy. Just like the vegans that make this world to a better place. Let me be honest. All revolutionary activists around whole history been always in the eyes of the oppressors, crazy, radicals, villains. But this is because they're not thinking what's it ever from the position of the victims. If you are not a victim, so have I explained before, Don't imagine it entirely from your point of view. Because if you are not a victim, it becomes pretty easy to do a lot of evil stuff. From making fun of your victims. Like slaughterhouse workers doing that hellholes that are called slaughterhouses. To make fun and deny your victims the right to live a long and happy life. Say that they're being inanimate objects and that they're not can think. So easy if you are the victim. But when you are the victim, things look a lot different, is it not? Slavery was once legal. And the slave liberationists were called crazy, enemies of civilization. And I think slaveness as well now call the people that have been opposed to slavery terrorists. But you don't have to believe rich people in their words. It's particularly rich people and people that have to have something to lose. Or think that they have something to lose. Because they make always lies up. They create some lie in the heart. And use strawman fallacies to protect their evil behavior. And that's deceitful lies. Awaken humanity. And come to your humility. We vegans are not the extremists. That been the same kind of mindset that the slave masters have. That been the people that been the oppressors. We been the ones that been the liberationists. Just like the Allied forces. They have watched the position of Nazism from the position of the Jews and the Gypsies and the mentally retarded people that Hitler labeled worthless, despicable and displaceable and murdered in mass. Just like the Underground Railroad and Harriet have watched it from the position of the slaves. They've been turned into objects by the dictatorial powers of the government and a cold, hard, mind-blowing status quo. I will be so harsh as the truth, as uncompromisable as justice, and in the end you will see that I was right. Stand on the side of the victims, if you choose right from wrong. That means animals. Oppressors don't need your voice. The victims are the only ones that deserve your protection. Choose sides. Neutrality helps the oppressor. Not the oppressed. Silence incurs the tormentor, not the tormented. Come up. Look it from the position of the animals. If you honestly place yourself in the animal's position, there's no way that you can justify it. The murder, the kidnapping of their children's, the commodification of their life, them turning in inanimate objects. I've never heard one excuse that even come close to a justification of what we do to them. Not even once. because if you say it tastes so delicious, the rapist can also use that. They can also say rape is too delicious that I don't want to give it up. Jeffrey Demons can also say something like that, just like Isaac Watanu. Takeaway, yes. Isaac, takeaway. But that all not in a courtroom. At least not in a just courtroom. One that's not discriminating. One that not listened to the lullaby of a madman's. That say, might is right, power is justice. We are the defenders. Meat eaters are the vandals. We stand for animals. We've been their voice. But if the meat eater, carnist, or the flesh eater, or the zombie, so some vegans so funny call them, to protect. Same things that slave masters us. Same thing that white cis male of, and black cis male in Turkey, and in the Islamic State, or ISIS. If you are not a victim, don't imagine it entirely from your point of view. Humans are a marvelous curiosity. When they're on the very, very best, they're a kind of low-grade, nickel-plated angel. When they're on the worst, they've been inexplicable, unbelievable, and unforgivable. But by all the times and all the means, there is a sarcasm. And they're all called themselves, in all sincerity, the most wise and noblest work or God or nature. When their history show the opposite. When darkness and light become one, the reality splintered away and the truth become visible. The lie cannot live forever. Sadly, lies can live for hundreds, sometimes even thousands of years. When the world come one day that the lie will be broken. One generation will break the chains. Be the generation. People. Stand on the side of the victims and make not the same mistakes as your ancestors. Violence have always to come in peace with compassion, decency and kindness. Not the other way around. So much people believe that if you've been peaceful, it will bring automatically peace. As Gary Rofsky once have said, great inspiration of me. People are willing to listen to the message of veganism or not. No matter how you talk, you can be so kind as Gandhi or Dr. Luther King, or you can be so radical as Malcolm X, but this will maybe nothing change somebody's position on the subject of veganism. It is all on the person in question if they're being ready to listen. But nothing gave up. Nothing gave up to speak for the defenseless. Nothing gave up to speak against systematic oppression. Nothing give up. Let always your voice heard. For the ones that not can speak for themselves. Because you are the only chance for them to give their freedom. Many vegan compassion to all my subscribers. And all of you, I hope I have inspired with this video and with my other videos. I've over 350 different videos. So if you want to check more about me, check them out. Mate, see you next time.
Break the law, even if that costs prison imprisonment. That can think of out of the box, and that can fight in any situation the good part of it. People that even if the darkness have overwhelmed them, can see the light. The people that not give up, even if the war between to win. People that stand for justice, no matter if that means that they're being called radical, no matter what they're being called idealistic, no matter all the whole society is against it. Crazy people. True justice fighters have been always called radical. Malcolm X, Gandhi, Martin Luther King Jr., Cesar Chavez, have been always called radical and crazy people at the time. Don't mean that they've been crazy. That means that they're being people that don't want them told by the massa what they have to believe. People that found their own reality. Not people that lose the reality, lose anything around them, think that suffering is good, and murder is good, and torment is good. Just like this all the time. I say, don't tell me what I have to think of, what I have to think. Even if my choices are being evil. But I don't see it. But I have blinders. I have blinders. Oh, I see not the victim. Oh, that's not a problem. There's no problem. There's no problem. No. Don't tell me what I have to do. Let me alone. Crazy people say, interesting. But, crazy people, they have not to understand. But insane people, yes, insane people, they always look to the actions of people that are being insane or not. People that are being insane, they're not to get rid of their own medicine. Get punched in the face and get back to reality. And realize that I'm not being the only things on the planet. That I need only, that I mean not the only ones that have to fight to be free. That not the whole world is their prophet. Being other living creatures that's just like humans. Same thing that people be more important than cows, chickens, turkeys. It's also insane that black people discrimination in its essence is evil. And it's in its essence insane. It's the insane victimizer mindset. It's the crazy mindset of the freedom fighter. That's what the people call me crazy. They're not reality. But they don't want to accept it. Or maybe see the mistakes in the path of the society and wants to change them. And to explain it why. And when people don't want to listen, yes, then you have a reason. For the victims to force it to them. People that don't listen to the logic. Sometimes they have to be treated in other way. People that want not to listen to pacifists, they actually choose to be forced to listen to aggressive activism. Dania also going in the zone. We have the Black Panthers. We have the Malcolm X. It's how it's not one way. Maybe the whole entire society is insane in the treating of victims. It's insane to protect victimizers when the victims in the wind up being needed to protect the victimizers. They're assholes. The victims, they're not. The victims, they're innocent. The victimizers that endured and they deserve their punishment. Set up for the right. The world is not. The world is becoming a horrible place. Not because of the people that are evil. It's because of the people that don't set up for the right. We can't bring peace on this world. But we have to stop the insanity of humanity. We can do it together. Crazy people being only different. That's not something that is bad. Insane people that have lost any form of rationality. And they don't want to change, no matter what. And why we let these people in life. Why protect victimizers? Protect the victims. They are needed. The victimizers that can choose to go not. So, protect the victims.
Until animals are included in all discussions of equality, to hell with any two-legged oppressed creature who can't even realize the oppression they are actively taking part in every time they sit down to a meal or buy a pair of shoes. One struggle, one fight, animal liberation. Fuck human rights.